The 2020s, things were never the same after that. That's when we saved the world. Only we almost didn't.
It all changed once we realized the difference working with nature could make. Back then, we were all about electric cars, renewable energy, reducing our dependence on fossil fuels. And they were all crucial, but on their own, they never would have been enough. We were already facing an extinction-level threat. We thought we were doing a lot, but we needed to do even more. Enter nature. The most sophisticated system for processing greenhouse gases in the universe only had hundreds of millions of years on us. We had to stop the planet from warming more than 1.5 degrees Celsius compared to the start of the 20th century. Turns out we had to be kind to nature. Hear me out. Stopping the destruction of existing forests, grasslands, and wetlands pulled 3.9 billion metric tons of carbon out of the atmosphere. Smarter farming and forestry techniques cut another 5.1 billion tons. And restoring the forests and wetlands we had lost scrubbed another 2. That's 11 billion tons of carbon removed from the atmosphere. That's like a string of SUVs stuck in bumper-to-bumper traffic stretching from here to the moon 56 times over. That's 1/3 of the emission reductions we needed. How's it work, though? Pick a tree. Any tree. Look closer. Trees do this awesome thing called photosynthesis where they soak up rays of sun and pluck carbon from the air to feed themselves. They literally eat the stuff that traps heat in our atmosphere. And have you heard of mangroves? They're like trees, but they live along the coast near bays and beaches. They became all the rage when word got out they could store 5 times more carbon than their landlocked counterparts. Plus, as they age, trees, all plants really, deposit their carbon into soil. Other plants use that to grow, some of which get eaten by animals, like us, which release carbon back into the atmosphere, starting the whole process over again. It's called the carbon cycle, and it worked really well for a really long time until we overloaded the system by burning fossil fuels and cutting down too many of our forests. It can look very natural now, but protecting and restoring nature at a global level was one of the hardest things we've ever done, and we still had to reduce our dependence on fossil fuels. But once we realized it would take more than switching to renewable energy, once we really partnered with nature to reduce our carbon footprint, and also to live on a better planet,
that's when we really started to save the world.